Welcome back, mineralogy fans. A reasonable place to start when talking about minerals is the silicate mineral group, built up from the silica tetrahedra. And a good backdrop for this discussion is the Bowen's reaction series, which details the order in which silicate minerals come out of a generic igneous melt. We see the first minerals to solidify would be olivine and calcium-rich plagioclase feldspar, or CA plag for short. The right side of this chart is called the continuous series and describes a solid solution for plagioclase feldspar going from calcium-rich to sodium-rich. And calcium-sodium, they have similar ionic charge and radius and thus can swap out for each other in this solid solution. On the left side, we see the discontinuous series, which shows that after olivine crystallizes from a melt, we expect pyroxene to form, then amphibole, biotite mica, orthoclase feldspar, muscovite mica, and finally quartz. Now let's look down to the molecular level, and I've made it abundantly clear that all these silicate minerals are built up from the silica tetrahedra. But a single silica tetrahedra has an overall charge of -4. This is way out of neutral, and nature loves to reach neutrality. Take a look at the top of this chart of the discontinuous side. Olivine is a mineral that is called a nesosilicate, from the Latin root nesos, which means island. These crystals have islands of silicate tetrahedra, which are bound together and electrically neutralized by cations, mostly of iron and magnesium. When you can substitute out one ion for another in the mineral formula, like here, iron can substitute magnesium or vice versa, we refer to the mineral species as a solid solution. Next on the discontinuous series is pyroxene. Besides simply adding cations, another way to neutralize -4 complex silica tetrahedra ions is for them to share corners. Two isolated tetrahedra have an overall charge of -8, but if they share an oxygen at one of their corners, the charge imbalance is reduced down to -6. The more shared corners, the lower the overall charge imbalance, and the fewer cations needed to balance everything out. Pyroxenes take the first step in this direction and shares a single corner to make silica tetrahedra single chains. Pyroxene is a dark-colored mineral with two directions of cleavage at nearly right angles. Logically, the next most efficient way to reduce charge is a double chain, and when this happens, we call it amphibole. A similarly dark-colored mineral with two planes of cleavage, but this time at 54 and 126 degree angles, almost 6120. Amphibole looks like pyroxene, except for this difference of cleavage angles, and that is controlled by their respective crystallography, single chain versus double chain. The next logical step is to link three corners of the tetrahedra into sheets. And these are the micas and many clays, which have one direction of cleavage along the sheet faces. The most complex silicates are tectosilicates, which have three-dimensional sharing of the silica tetrahedra corners. These make up the most common minerals in the Earth's crust. We've already seen the most common mineral of the Earth's crust, the plagioclase solid solution, ranging from calcium-rich to sodium-rich. But at the bottom of the Bowen's reaction series is potassium feldspar, or K-spar, and quartz, which respectively are the next two most common minerals on the Earth's surface. Right there are most of the Earth's crust. All three of these are tectosilicates, which means three-dimensional linking of the silicate tetrahedra. Sharing the most tetrahedral corners, these tectosilicates of feldspar and quartz need fewer cations to neutralize them into a stable mineral and concentrate more potassium, aluminum, and some rarer elements like uranium. The Bowen's reaction series also tells us which minerals will melt first when heated and which minerals are more or less chemically stable at the surface. Olivine is a rare mineral at the Earth's beaches, but quartz is rather common. Don't make your tombstone out of mafic minerals of olivine, pyroxene, amphibole, or calcium-rich plagioclase feldspar. Use quartz if possible. There's a reason the sandy beaches and deserts of the world are predominantly quartz grains. Our exploration of silicate minerals will follow a logical progression from the most to least common. almost half of the minerals making up the Earth's crust are feldspars, and another quarter to quartz. We will cover 3/4 of all the minerals you will ever encounter in the next episode, the feldspars and quartz.